But what about the Vice President, Mike Pence?
He's welcome. I think it's important that as much as we can stick to what have been the historical precedents of how and the circumstances in which an administration changes should be maintained. And so if the Vice President is welcome to come, we'd be honored to have him there and to move forward in the transition.
Have you spoken to him at all?
No, I haven't.
But after the events of Wednesday, does that make your job easier or harder?
I just think that if you look at it, speaking to some of my Republican colleagues, and I've spoken to a number of them over the last month since we've been elected, through recently as the day in which this god-awful debacle was taking place up on the Hill. And I think they understand that they're going to have to, we need a Republican Party. We need an opposition that's principled and strong. And I think you're going to see them going through this idea of what constitutes a Republican Party. And to hear some of my colleagues, Republican colleagues, talk about how shameful it is of the way Ted Cruz and others are dealing with this, how they're responsible as well for what happened.
Do you think some of them should resign? Should Senator Cruz or Senator Hawley resign?
I think they should be just flat beaten the next time they run. I think the American public has a real good, clear look at who they are. They're part of the big lie. The big lie. I was being reminded by a friend of mine, maybe you were with me, I can't recall, when we were told that, you know, Goebbels and the great lie, you keep repeating the lie, repeating the lie. Well, there was a print that when Dresden was bombed, firebombed, there were 250 people that were killed, or was it 2,500 people were killed? And Goebbels said, no, 25,000 or 250,000 were killed. And our papers printed that. Our papers printed it. It's the big lie. People will know. It's one thing for one man, one woman, to repeat the lie over and over and over again. By the way, Trump said that before he ran. If you say it enough, I'm going to convince you. I'll say it enough. The press is bad. The press is bad. The press is bad. The press is bad. If he's the only one saying it, that's one thing. But the acolytes that follow him, like Cruz and others, they are as responsible as he is. And so it's not about whether or not they get impeached. It's about whether or not they help, can continue to hold power because of the disgust the American people have for their actions. There are decent people out there who actually believe.